Hello, my name is Troels Kirk. I'm the owner and proprietor and builder of the Coastline Railroad, a model railroad in Owen 30, set in 1930s Maine. Today I'll finish or try to finish the last remaining couple of feet of water to do on this coastal line. There's a lot of water here. The waves are small in this area, and I'll be shooting a little video of the technique I use for these wavelets, or whatever they are called. My medium is this one, Liquitex. I'll try to have it focused. Liquitex super heavy gloss gel and acrylic from the artist's supply stores. And my tool is mostly this little palette knife used to blend colors for artists again. The smallest you can get will do it just fine. Now, onto the modeling. Well, as you can see, the coast is already prepared with the beach, and I've painted a slightly graded greenish, bluish color on the masonite foundation for the sea, this one. And I'll always begin nearest to the coast when doing the water. It feels easier that way. I start by applying a bit of this acrylic at a time, shaping it as I go, pressing down and lifting up to get waves crashing. I don't know if you can see it clearly here, but I'll try pulling it up where it meets the shore. Some more, press down, squeeze it up tight to the coast. It will dry up completely clear in the end and can then be painted. I'll work my way a little down the coast. There's a lot of ways of doing it, I'm sure, but this has proven very easy to control and very reliable too. I now flatten the area in front of the waves. I pull my finger outwards to make some small tracks where the waves have been recently. And I also lift up my finger to raise the tops a little. This was the first row of many. And I come back with the next one. Again, crashing into the coast, making it a little rough, small tops everywhere, where the echo from the coast comes out again through the waves, the small waves. They're not really waves, they're just wavelets. I'll make a new row of waves out here, thickly applied gel medium. Lift it up a little, tease it up, and even pull it up slightly like this, roll it up. Occasionally I use a toothpick or something like that to lift the tops up. Don't get it too heavy, too thick, because then it will never dry. In that case, for the larger waves, I use polyfiller elastic spackle instead. Much easier to use. And when painted and lacquered, or varnished or whatever, you won't see that it's a solid white compound in the beginning. working my way out still. Now I can just start with the gentler waves. I use a wiggling, gentle wiggling stroke. I'll try once more. I flatten it out very well like this, smear it in lengthwise, and then wiggle my palette knife just a little. Here and there I lift up the tops just to agitate the sea a little. The crashing wavelets by the coast are only the two or three rows or so in this gentle breeze, nothing more than that. Wiggle, wiggle, all the time. Well, I've almost completed the water on the remaining section of water on the coastline. This is a big day for me. Many feet of water has been finished over the years, and this little stretch has taken me forever to do. I've been waiting for a long time to do this and never got around to it. So it's a big day for me. Over here the water is already finished, and now I'm just preparing the place where the tiny schooner will be lying, along the wharf, the tiny wharf here, the salt wharf. So I'm now smearing a thin layer of this gel. Where the ship will be lying, just to glue it to the surface. And I'm placing my little schooner where it needs to be for the rest of its stays. It will be very firmly glued by this. If you want to, you can always remove it while the gel is still soft and leave the impression of it. And then you can put it in place when the waves are dry, but I'll risk this. It looks good already. Now I'll slowly blend the small wavelets in along the waterline of the hull, very carefully, not so carefully actually, just trying to make it look natural. There we go. Slowly does it all the time. I'm always impatient, trying to do things too fast, and you are never rewarded for that. I'm absolutely certain. Well, here we come. Slowly down the waterline. Ever so gently, not to smear too much up on the hull. Looks unnatural, you know. You can always scrape it off afterwards if you make some mistakes. Try to get the waves calm and nice around here. There's not much action actually in this stretch of water. Just a little wind, just a little wake of a passing ship or something like that. Not much. Slowly wiggle my way a little into the already finished water stretch. Here we go around the corner. Now there's only the cosmetic filling of small holes and voids before I can leave it to dry, and have to wait a couple of days before I can color the crests with a little acrylic white or bluish white and see the result. I will of course shoot a little close-ups of the finished water in a few days. A couple of days has gone by now and the acrylic gel has almost dried. It's still a bit milky down here in the biggest wavelets, but I'll show you what to do next. I use a blend of slightly bluish white to accent all the foamy white caps, crests or waves or what you call them, especially along the coast. Always remove a little with the fingers and spread it out ever so gently. Just hit the tops of the waves I've created. Over here too, this big wave, biggish, ever so gently. Just touch the tops, rub it out with your fingers occasionally, just to simulate the foam left in the water when the wave moves. And the next crests over here too, gently does it. Along the coast in here, and so on. It's very easy to do, just don't overdo it, because then it will just look silly. This is no storm, no storm waves either, so keep it simple and go watch the real thing. Water is very difficult to do by imagination. You have to take a good look at the real thing and then try to copy it gently along the coast here. A little here, more there, taking care not to destroy the schooner. You get the drift now. Just hit a few crests with a little action. That's about it. I'll complete them now and then come back to show you how it looks when it's dry.